Hello, thanks for the subscription. Yeah, I had to choose this song because another Chavin song I used another day made the video got muted because they say it has copyright. This is a somewhat cheap microscope, an OptoEdu, a higher microscope camera, although any camera should suffice, and just that. I'm using an oblique lighting filter I made by painting a plastic disc with some black paint. if you're interested in microscopy, I will post some links in the chat of other Twitch streamers that do stuff with microscopy that you might like. It's also very relaxing, just putting something in there and watching. That last one hasn't been streaming for long. I think he's still preparing the stuff. And I'm not sure I remember other streamers. At least not that they dedicate more time to the microscopy. When I started with the microscope, I thought it was going to be harder, but it's just being careful not break anything and putting stuff and just experimenting. I don't know if I have ever seen him or her. It doesn't sound familiar. Thank you. Yeah, this is from Root. No, my entire I'm talking. Okay. I think that hum is because I raised the volume of the mic too much, but if I don't raise it, people don't hear me. I have no idea what this is. I think it's eating a rotifer, but I'm not sure of the organism. There's also those tendrils that are moving. I don't know if they could be bacteria. Yeah, that's how would I eat. In fact, this one just pooped and the whirlpool pushed the poop back into his mouth. All of those tiny stuff coming out of the mouth, I think they are the particles that couldn't make it inside. Another whirlpool. Yeah, this is one of the most lively ones I have. These ones I have hydras, snails, flatworms, rotifers, a lot of algae. These amoebas are crazy. They can flow quickly, but sometimes they get kinda rigid. If it still works, you could take it out. Maybe you can find some pieces, like some objectives that are compatible, and improve it. Or maybe it looks good on its own. I started seeing them several days after I took the samples. I think they need some time to grow. But there are a lot of different species in the ones I've found. When people teach about amoebas, it's always the same genetic kind, the same shape. But when I started seeing amoeba, I was surprised to see all of the variations they have. still don't know what these are. They're everywhere. A lot of times they are like this in pairs, stuck from the mouth, because they have a small opening in the front. I haven't seen them move. And a lot of time one of them also has like some kind of inner wall. I don't know if these are an organism like a testate amoeba or an oocyte. Yeah, maybe, but I'm not sure what the organism is. And if these are two different ones, and one of them is creating a cyst, or it's one that's creating another shell and moving the contents. Because when I've seen them stuck like this, it's always one that has this cyst-like formation. So this sample is becoming more saline because its water is evaporating. Will it fix it if I add some distilled water? Okay. just have to remember from when I took this. Or just empty my jars and took them all over from the start. Yes, it is. And that little thing on top might be a mite or a lice. I don't know if it's a if it could be a parasite of this or it's just there for the ride. I think I haven't watched a tick in the microscope. Yeah, I've seen a lot of animals now that don't get hurt by the hydra. Every little animal I try to feed them, they just ignore them. Also, I think this one has 6 legs. Yes, but first I have to put a cover slip on top to protect the hydra. I freeze them in cold. Nidocyst, nematocyst. Here, those smaller long cells have some kind of coil inside, and the other round ones have the harpoon. I think one of them is to sting the prey and the other is to attach to it. I read that. This is when that fired. They also have T cells all over their bodies. I always thought only the tentacles had the stingers, so I don't know if these can also sting or are there for another thing. Because they also look like they have harpoons. I don't know if he hasn't been stung now. Also, maybe the Hydra has too little space between the cover slips to open the mouth. Testing. There are a lot of nidocysts stuck to the mite. So if I don't know, it should already be paralyzed if it was affected. It's covered in the things. I don't know if the exoskeleton is too hard to be penetrated by the stingers. But with this size, it would already be dead. I once saw a hydra sting a nematode, and it was instantly paralyzed. Maybe. But I don't know if the ones that already triggered can still inject venom, or they have to be new stingers. The mite also has a little passenger. No, I think it's on the surface. It looks painful how it clings to the skin of the hydra. Hello, Estidal. Thank you. I don't know if this one is a mite. I thought mites were arachnids. This one has 6 legs. It kinda looks like none of them knows that the other is there. It's stuck on the glue in the Hydra's foot. Maybe. I'm not sure how they look like. It got trapped in the glue. Thank you. it's getting late here, so I'll just end the stream. I think it was okay for today. Thank you for watching. I'll see if I can write someone.